Hey guys, this is David Kwan. So, I'm a really big fan of Splinter Cell franchise. Before Double Agent, because Double Agent made me lose a lot of respect for the franchise as a whole. But yeah, I love Splinter Cell games, and because of that, I've always been interested in playing Splinter Cell Conviction. I just haven't been able to at all because PlayStation 3 is really the only console I own. I never owned a 360. Don't plan on getting it anytime ever soon. And MacBook is the only the computer I have. I haven't owned a Windows PC for the longest time, for years now. So I just haven't had a platform to be able to play it. But recently I was able to play it via Onlive, because it's one of those games I can get through Onlive. And Onlive, it doesn't matter what kind of computer you have, as long as you have a great internet connection, you can play the game that you pretty much purchase, which it works really well. Splinter Cell Conviction is actually my very first full-fledged Onlive experience. And from it, I have to say Onlive is pretty amazing. I hope this technology goes beyond so that, being able to stream and play like a game without having to download the whole thing, without having a computer capable of running a thing, Onlive is fantastic. But yeah, let's talk about Splinter Cell Conviction. It irks me in a lot of ways because it is such a departure from the franchise as a whole. But at the same time, it's a really fun game because it's such a departure from the series as a whole. That's not to say that the series as a whole needed to, have this jump. I think if they give me another game a lot like Splinter Cell Chaos Theory, I'd be all over that. I'm still not done with that kind of gameplay style. But I think Ubisoft decided that this series needed to go more mainstream and decided to have, more action experience to it, that they went this route with Splinter Cell Conviction. That's not the part that irks me, though. The part that irks me the most is this game tries to have this, like, Jason Bourne, Bourne Identity, those Bourne movies. It wants to have that kind of feeling and the vibe. So they decided to make non-lethal option no longer an option. Splinter Cell, Sam Fisher in this game kills a lot. That bothers me a lot, really, because I remember making this blog sometime back about Spec Ops The Line, and I said something to the effect of, man, I can't think of any other game where the main enemy that I'm killing are American soldiers. And then I realized, as I'm playing Splinter Cell Conviction, oh, that's because I haven't played Splinter Cell Conviction yet. So this is another game where, majority of the time, the enemies Sam Fisher is fighting are Americans. They're former echelon operatives. And Sam Fisher is no longer third echelon. So he's killing his, former co-workers. There's no option to non-lethally take down enemies, except in one chase sequence. But it feels it's weird because there are police officers, and the president of the United States, Sam, you can't kill anyone. So that's like the only time in the game where you're just running, there's this chase sequence and there are cops in the way, and then you just knock them out. But the knock them out button kills people in this game. There is no knockout or kill. It's just kill, which is just irksome to me, just because these are Sam's former co-workers or people that Sam trained, the organization that Sam used to work for. It bothers me because it's a retcon of the biggest sort. Sam, when I played Splinter Cell, the previous games, we're taking down terrorists. And unless it's the freaking terrorist leader and stuff, I usually never killed, because I like the concept of not leaving a trace that I was there. So I was always this stealthy player who tried to use as least amount of gadgets and weapons as possible, but it's still fun to use non-lethal gadgets, like the electronical jamming device and sticky camera. It was really fun to use those awesome devices, but at the same time, I tried to make it so that I'm non-lethal as possible, and if things got hairy, I knocked people out. Those are terrorists. Splinter Cell Conviction, I'm not going against terrorists. Sure, these are actually they are terrorists, but these are domestic terrorists. They're American operatives gone kind of crazy, you know? But it's not their choice. I mean, well, maybe it is their choice, but they're headed by the third echelon director. So when Sam is taking down terrorists, he takes them out non-lethally. But when he's taking out his own people that he used to work with, he's killing them. That's really irksome to me. And that was really like one thing that bugged me throughout the course of the game. The storyline is really kind of messy too, because they want to have the story where Sam is considered the rogue agent and the enemy he's fighting is the agency that he used to work for. That is the premise that Ubisoft wants to kind of establish here. And I understand that. That is a pretty interesting premise to work around. But you have a very messy storyline here. It's just kind of like, okay, so that's what happened. And this villain, you know, it's not very cohesive what happens at the end. And I think Splinter Cell was best when it really didn't have to deal with all this kind of storyline crap. Splinter Cell, the first three games, told the story through news clips, the world news broadcasting or whatever, WMB, I don't remember exactly the name, but it broadcasted, it had some missions in different locales, and it kind of vaguely tied in the terrorist threat altogether. But now it's just trying to have this really cohesive narrative thing going on, and it's too much. Splinter Cell is not Metal Gear. Like, it doesn't need that big of a story element to it. And I think it ruins the experience because of that. There are some scenes in this game where it's to propel the story forward. It kind of makes sense, but it really hinders the gameplay. Like, the part where we go to Iraq. It's like a third-person shooter sequence, so it just totally goes against what Splinter Cell is even all about, first of all. So it's like that Middle Eastern part sequence in Splinter Cell Double Agent, which was a horrible gameplay segment, because you can't really be stealthy, but you're asked to be stealthy. I mean, it's just so odd that this is in this game. It doesn't have the Splinter Cell vibe. That's the thing about it. The gadgets are not, there are not many gadgets to use. There is a sticky camera thing, but it's not really all that useful in this game. Most of the time, you're using weapons, which can be upgraded, which is cool. Most of the times, you're using all kinds of different guns, shotguns, sniper rifles, assault rifles, silent pistols, and you can kind of upgrade and customize them. So that's really cool. There are really cool ideas in here in this game. I don't want to knock this game up too much because I really did enjoy quite a bit of this game. It's not a game where I'm just going like, why was this even made? Little Agent, I really don't think Double Agent should have been a game ever made at all. But Conviction, I enjoyed the hell out of it. There's some great concepts here. Mark and Execute is an interesting concept. It lets you get out of hairy situations. I really like the fact that once you're discovered, you know, and you can just kind of run away from the scene and hide, and the enemies still think you're here because that's Sam's last known position. This idea of Sam's last known position is something that really is needed in this franchise, because one of the biggest gripe that I've always had about Splinter Cell as a series is the fact that once Sam is discovered, everyone knows where you are. It doesn't even matter if the whole room is pitch black and no one has a flashlight. Everyone knows where you are, and the enemy aim of their guns is so completely accurate that once discovered, Splinter Cell becomes no longer fun. And that's always something I preferred Metal Gear over Splinter Cell. Metal Gear and Splinter Cell are stealth games. Splinter Cell is more stealthy in the fact that you kind of, you know, there's whole lots of missions based around stealth. But Metal Gear is a game where if you're discovered, you have the enemy AI is structured around such that you can maneuver, you can continue to be stealthy after you get out of that situation. With Splinter Cell games, I usually almost always played on hard difficulty and just died and started, reloaded my last save or something. Or I required, like, because the game requires you to kill everyone in the room because everyone knows where you are. That was my biggest gripe with Splinter Cell, and Conviction addresses that with this new innovative idea of last known, Sam's last known position. So overall, like, I really enjoyed the experience of Conviction, but It's the lethalness of Sam Fisher was out of his character. Just felt really irksome for the franchise. I'm really glad that Splinter Cell Blacklist is going to have non-lethal option again. Ironically, because he's tracking down terrorists again, not his countrymen, so he's not going to kill because it's not his countrymen. So ironic. Blacklist looks to have such an amazing array of gadgets, which Conviction lacked. And it has the same mark and execute system, which, I don't know, I got used to it. It's kind of neat, but at the same time, it is like I win button. You know, as a stealth game, I don't know if it needs that much, but it's there. I guess it's there to stay for the franchise. It's an interesting departure for the franchise. It feels like a reboot more than anything else. It's one way that this franchise has kind of gone over to the next generation and is trying to stay relevant. I'm really excited for Blacklist, but at the same time, I feel like this is the direction that the franchise has taken. It's kind of disappointing, because I love the Chaos Theory, Pandora Tomorrow, or the original Stealth Action Redefined type of gameplay as well. And that type of game is so rare in this industry, that now Splinter Cell has just become another third-person shooter with different stealth elements and, you know, cover-to-cover jumping mechanic. It has a lot of mechanics and cool, neat ideas, but it's now become just a third-person shooter with stealth elements. It no longer has that trademark Splinter Cell vibe and feel to it. And I think that's kind of disappointing. Did it have to do that in order to become mainstream and make more sales? I don't know. That's another topic altogether that I personally wouldn't be able to answer because I'm not an expert on that topic. But to me, as someone who really loved the original classic feel of Splinter Cell, I feel like Splinter Cell as a franchise departed away from what made it Splinter Cell too much so that it no longer is what it used to be. It's a delicate balance that franchises have to maintain as it has more and more sequels. How does it change to bring fresh new things, but how does it stay relevant in the franchise? Double Agent was just a horrible game. It wasn't the fact that it departed from the franchise. But we have Conviction, which is a great game, but it departed so much away from what makes it feel like Splinter Cell, I think. And that's what's most disappointing to me. But at the same time, because it's a fun experience, I do realize that, you know, it wasn't a failure. It was definitely like one of the steps they could have taken, and this is the route they have taken. I would like to see a more return to the vibe of Splinter Cell and Blacklist, which is what I feel like Ubisoft from every trailer I look at. Blacklist, I think, is a more return to the form of Splinter Cell, which I think is awesome. But yeah, but with these the ideas that Conviction introduced, like Mark and Execute, which makes things accessible. But as the fan of the original Splinter Cell games, it's not really what I play Splinter Cell games for. I find it neat, but it's not something that I'm like, you know, it's just like, wow, this is so awesome kind of thing, you know.